So this may be the coolest video I think that I've ever done. And I've been waiting for a long time to do it now. It might even be cooler than when I got to get behind the wheel of the Tesla Model 3, and I love that one. So this spring, my wife and I decided to do a little work up here on top of our house. Or, okay, actually, we paid somebody else to do the work, but you get the idea. We went solar-ish. I'll explain that in a minute. Here's the thing though, okay? I know that this isn't gonna be doable for everyone. I totally get that. It's gonna have a lot to do with where you live. It's gonna have a lot to do with your house itself and the direction it faces. It's gonna have a lot to do with the things around your house. What you're gonna get here is my experience with the whole solar thing. We're gonna start with the questions I had before I even had any idea if this was feasible for us. Yeah, we're gonna talk about the money, okay? We're gonna talk about how much this cost. I will absolutely tell you. And we're gonna talk about how much I might be saving. So you ready? Let me get down from here. We'll go do this. So here's how we're gonna do this thing. I wanna start with the questions that I had before a single solar panel went up there on the roof. First, why should we do this? What is the purpose? Am I gonna save the planet? Of course not. Am I gonna save a little money? Maybe. Is it gonna be a combination of the two? Yeah. And then the obvious question, how much is it going to cost? Is this gonna be affordable for us at all? And then kind of the technical question, what can solar do? What can it do? Is it even gonna be feasible here where I live? Obviously it was. So we started with three estimates from three companies. Take your time, absolutely get more than one quote. Now the first thing you're gonna do for almost any of these though is send them a copy of your power bill. Mine, one of the last 12 months, that was simple enough to pull off their website, real easy. That'll give them an idea of how much power we use month to month, so they'll know how big a system they need to design. And once they had that, they took our address and they plugged it all into a little computer program that takes a look with satellite pictures and says, all right, here's where you live, here's how much sun you'll get throughout the year, here are all the trees that are nearby, and here's how big of a solar system we need to build for you. Other questions we had were a little more technical, if overly simple, right? Like, what happens at night or when clouds are overhead? Do we lose power? Is there some weird manual switchover we have to do? Is there any maintenance involved? Or what happens with the excess electricity that hopefully we'll be generating? And a big one for us here in Florida, if and when the next hurricane comes, are these solar panels just essentially gonna turn into a big wing and lift our roof off the house? So you can never ask too many questions here. And here's one more really important thing to know, and it's really the reason why I did this year. Right now, there's a 30% federal tax credit for renewable energy. So essentially, if we did this year, we'd be able to lop off almost a third of the cost of it. Now, taxes can be a little more complicated than they need to be, I know, but here's the real basic gist of it. Right now, at first, technically, we're only paying interest only on the loan, although we're actually paying ahead. Now, in 2020, when we file our 2019 taxes, we're gonna get a whole chunk of money back, right? More than $10,000. And you take that money and you apply it back to the loan. And that's where that savings comes in. Now the credit is 30% through 2019. Next year in 2020, it drops down to 26%, and it'll drop down to 22% in 2021. So that's why we went ahead and did all this year. Now every good company is gonna walk you through this, okay? Take your time, ask a lot of questions. There are no dumb questions. And be sure to get multiple estimates. So two of the three local solar companies that I talked to in this whole little endeavor do some sort of home mitigation in conjunction with the solar. So the idea is if you take care of some of the other stuff in the house that maybe needs to be worked on, whether it's fixing the air conditioning ducts or doing something with insulation, then you don't need as many solar panels on top of the house, and that'll actually save you a little money maybe. And then the company that we ultimately decided to go with, what they offer is something even different. They will come into your attic, suck out all the old insulation that's up here, and put down spray foam. Now, if you've never seen spray foam before, just look it up on YouTube, right? There are a million videos. Super awesome. They have a hose and they spray it up here on the inside of the roof deck, and it expands and it seals all the gaps. So what it's gonna do is seal this entire attic, including up here in the ridge vent, and just make this big envelope to keep all the heat in, to keep all the cold air in. And I'm gonna oversimplify it, but what it really does is seal the entire house together, you know, to varying degrees. I'm in Florida, so we don't maybe worry about that the same way you would worry about it way up north, but it's gonna help for sure. And the idea is that it's gonna save us about 20% of our energy bill, right? The other 80% should be made up by the solar panels that are gonna be up on the roof. But even before we got to that point, I had a couple people come up and look at the roof and try to give me a lifespan on it, because as you can guess, when it's time to reshingle your roof, the solar stuff's all gonna have to come down and go back up, and that's an additional cost. We decided we have enough life left in ours. We're about halfway through, so it was time to get going. Now, the solar company should take care of everything, all right? They're gonna do all the designs, they're gonna do the engineering, they're gonna pull all the permits, and then they're gonna do the installation. All I had to do was wait. So first the rack system went up, and the wiring all runs through that, into the attic, and finally down into the electric box. Now, our system uses microinverters with one under every single solar panel, and that changes the direct current electricity created by the panels into alternating current that a residential home uses. That all gets fed into this control box before finally being fed into the house or back to the grid. Now, everything you see here may well vary a little bit depending on where you live and what regulations you have. Now, the panels went up after that. I've got 36 in all, each rated for 300 watts. I tell you, they went up remarkably fast. Once the rails were up, it's really just a matter of plopping them down, clipping in a couple of connections, bolting them into place, and they're done. And after that, we waited. Inspections by the city, and then finally by the power company, they took a couple weeks. Nothing I could do in the meantime. I just had solar panels to look at. And they were pretty, they just weren't doing anything yet. But we passed inspections, then it's time to start making electricity. So let's talk about the solar system itself. Again, it's gonna vary depending on what you get, where your house is, how much you need to generate, but here's what I've got. So the 36 300 watt panels and microinverters make up a 10.8 kilowatt hour system. Now, exactly how much energy we make on a daily basis depends on all sorts of things. If there's no sun, there's no solar energy, so some days are better than others. And what direction your home is facing matters as well. I have more room on the eastern side, so that's what we went with, even though south is really where you want to start. Now the time of year matters too, right? May, June, July, August, we were making a whole bunch of solar when the sun was out. I don't know what the difference is yet. We're gonna find out this winter, and it's gonna be really interesting to see. So once the system's up and running, there's really nothing for me to do except to sit back and let the panels do their thing. There isn't really any maintenance except to just make sure that there aren't any leaves or, you know, a whole lot of pollen on top of them, which is definitely a thing here in Florida. And of course, there's an app for all this. So I can see in relative real time exactly how much power is being made, and I can see stats for each day, month, year, and lifetime. It's pretty cool. I can't actually control anything because there's nothing to control though. And what I can't see is any real-time stats for how much power my house is using. I know there's third-party stuff you can plug into your electric box. I just haven't gotten there yet. It'd be really cool if my power company had that, but it doesn't. Anyway, when the sun's up, I'm making power, and that's what the home is using first. When the sun's down, or it's cloudy, or the house is just pulling more than I'm generating from the solar panels, then I'm pulling electricity from the grid. I'm absolutely still grid-tied. And that's actually kind of important because we don't have any way to store any of the energy we are creating. If we don't use it, it's sent right back to the grid. And at night, obviously, we gotta pull it from the power company. Now, maybe we'll look into batteries at some point. It's an additional cost. And actually, the company that did our install just started doing Tesla Powerwall, so that could be a really cool option. But again, it's a lot more money. Speaking of which, let's get down to the dirty details, the money and how much all of this cost. So first off, this 36 panel system and the spray foam in the attic cost about $37,600. So about as much as a pretty nice new car, right? Now we should get nearly $11,000 back next year from that tax credit, which we're then just gonna turn around and put right back into the loan. So call this whole thing, you know, $26,000 with nothing paid out of pocket. If you got cash you wanna put up front, that'll make the whole thing even less expensive over the long run. And what we said was, all right, we're still gonna have to pay the power company something. There's a minimum connection fee every month. It's about $25. So let's figure we gotta spend another $175, $200 a month paying off the solar and keep things relatively the same as what they were. We were paying the power company $200 before. Let's try to keep what we're paying for the solar about $200. So did our power bill shrink? Yeah, absolutely. I've got 6 months of use under our belts now, and here's where we're at. Since the solar system went live, I have not paid the power company any more than $25 a month. That's it. That's the minimum connection fee that we have to pay them just to be hooked up. So in other words, we've made more energy than we've used this summer. So sort of. All right, the excess energy all goes into this virtual bank at the end of the month. So you take what we've generated, subtract what we use from the grid, and anything left over goes there, okay? Now, if we have a month where we used more energy from the grid than we created, say there just wasn't so much sun, or it was super hot in the summer and we used the air conditioning all the time, then it will pull the difference out of that bank. And in fact, my bank's right about empty right now. It's been a really hot summer and we had a couple cloudy weeks, but I haven't had to pay the power company any more than that minimum $25 connection fee. So pretty much we're breaking even, which is exactly what we wanted when we went into this. So that was our experience moving our house to solar. Okay, not 100% solar, mostly solar. We're still tied to the grid. We're still gonna need their power, at least at night, right? But you get the idea, okay? We're trying to at least offset what we're using from the grid with renewable energy. I tell you, it's a little funny because now that we have all this up there, I'm trying to game the system a little bit, okay? I'm absolutely making sure that we keep lights off more often and we're not using the air conditioning nearly as much. Because the idea is I need to be able to pay for all these panels, right? And that's where the money's gonna go now. And maybe, just maybe, I feel like we're saving a tiny little sliver of the planet by doing this. I know it's not really true, but it makes me feel better, okay? Let me have that. So if you got any more questions about going solar or the federal tax credit or questions you should ask, hit me up in the comments, go find me on the socials. That's it, see you next time.